have no idea how this is gonna. Can you sit up?
I want a beanbag.
I don't know if I can get through this. 1, 2, 3. Hey, bye, mamas. So today is a very special video because I am joined by the Mr. to my Mrs. Mr. Rob. And we're gonna be doing an interview of him, just asking him some questions about our homeschooling journey so far and his thoughts about homeschooling. You ready? Mm-hmm. Okay. Were you homeschooled?
No.
Can you elaborate on that? What was your schooling like?
I went to public school in Chatham, New Jersey.
Chatham.
It was school. It was, you go to school, you know, that's all, you only get one choice. I mean, you don't get to experience multiple schools. You can't live your life twice it's not a multiverse, you know.
Mm, it's not a multiverse.
You get what you get and you don't get upset.
Neither of us were homeschooled. We both had, I guess, similar experiences with school. I remember it just being very rigorous. And were you able to be very creative in school, or what was it like?
Oh, you know, only in a couple classes. It was mostly you got to learn the way the teacher works. And then you just figure out, you know, for that classroom, what you have to do to do well.
Yeah, yeah. So following their standards and stuff.
Every teacher has their own standard. And that's the way it is in the real life. It's, you know, you have a new boss. Okay, how do they like to function? And figure that out. That's what I think is good about the whole system, but it's too much turnover. Having to learn a new system every year, plus having multiple bosses, like every classroom's a different boss. That's tough.
Never thought of it that way. All right, so now, what do you think about homeschooling? What did you think about homeschooling before we started? Because, so backstory, I was thinking about doing homeschool before our oldest went to kindergarten. So what were your thoughts about homeschooling before?
No, I just thought it was a thing, you know, it was something that you were kind of ready for before you did it.
What do you mean?
You know, you're just, people that were doing homeschool are like, yeah, we got to do homeschool. And I was never there in my mind.
Like being resolute about the decision to do homeschool.
Yeah, resolute. Yeah.
Yeah. So, but what did you think about the concept? Oh my gosh, my nose is dripping. What did you think about the concept of homeschooling? Don't look at me like that. It's just natural bodily functions. I wasn't into it, just so you know. I wasn't that into it before we started.
Well, the only thing I knew was that it's the results. You see a lot of these kids that are homeschooled, they come out pretty mature relative for their age. That's just my observation. Obviously, there's probably going to be exceptions to that.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Okay, so now, what do you think about homeschooling now? Now that we're homeschooling, so we're about a year and a half into the process.
I think it's good. I think it's hard, but it's not. I haven't really been doing. I've just been upstairs working all day. You know, trying to stay out of the way. And then I like to get Jesse at lunchtime and go on a run with him, even when it's freezing cold outside.
Yeah. Jesse came back one day like a statue. So bad.
He likes to play with
the geese. Oh my gosh.
My ducks. Yeah, that's the part that I like. I just hear status reports when I get your weekly reports from the kids.
The status.
She writes all these emails and has all these paragraphs.
Yeah, that's exactly what happens. Next question. So how do you support me and the kids?
Oh, money?
Aside from the obvious.
Yeah, I just, you know, I try to help reinforce the learning, read with the kids, do some math problems.
Yes, he's the math guy.
You know, hey, what's 10 minus 2, you know? And then, And then you know, kind of surprise them. You know, like when they're just about to eat their macaroni and cheese, you snatch it from them and say, what's 10 minus 2? Or, you know, we won't start a show until we get an answer. But
oh, my gosh.
You know, but then, yeah, you push back on that. I think it's fun. I think it's a good, you know, there's plenty of incentive for them to answer the question. So.
Yeah. Sometimes I push back because I'm like, I don't want them to feel forced to do it. But you're right. It's there's good incentive there. And it's all in good fun. We don't, like, force them to do something. We're not militant about it. Next question. What have been the pros and cons of our journey so far? Or I guess, you know, a better question would be, what are the highs and the lows? Or however you want to answer that.
The high was...
This is how I support him.
The highs are, you know, going through this thing and realizing that, you know, that you just get a different perspective on what school is.
Yeah.
And, you know, why have we as a society, so on such a vast level, just we give our kids to the system. I know not everyone is fortunate as we are with being able to live off of a single income. So that's a whole nother thing. But,
yeah,
you know, but I do see plenty of situations where you'll see a lot of families that, you know, for better or worse, they chose another path where they really could live off of one income, but they're choosing to use the systems, you know. And I just find that, you know, it's just something that the perspective changed on that.
Yeah.
This is, you know, I'm not trying to, it's not a judgment thing. It's just.
Right. It's what is to the, each their own. And it works for a lot of families. But I think for us, you know, it's been something that's been hard, right, would you say, at times? And then other times where we see the fruit of something, you know, and that feels rewarding at that point.
Well, I mean, you see it more than I do. I'm the principal upstairs.
He's behind the desk. The man behind the desk.
I only get sent the kids when they're in trouble.
When they're in trouble. Or you know what? You know what you're really good at? You're good at, Rob's good at playing with them. And, you know, giving them that opportunity at the end of the day to do that. We play during homeschool and I let the kids play, but more often than not, I'm not as involved in it as I would probably want to be. I think that's my own, like, conservation of energy.
I want to get, you know, outside as much as possible is my goal. It's just so hard at this time of year because it gets dark at 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
And so the only time I get out now is with the kids or with Jesse at lunchtime. But we are trying this new thing with the garage where we...
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Get the cars out of the garage, leave the door closed, and turn the lights on.
Yeah, and let them play outside. That's been good. That's been good for winter time.
Use their bikes.
It's slightly warmer in there than it is outside, and then they can, like, kind of, use their bikes and scooters to kind of move around and have fun that way. How do you see homeschooling helping our kids succeed in the future? Like, how might it benefit our kids to be homeschooled?
You know, it's just confidence in who they are as a person is what you hope, and not a haughtiness, but a confidence.
Yeah.
So that they, you know, they know the value of time, and they know the value of who they are and what they're doing. You know, and then just to have that, hopefully to have a drive. But you know, everybody has to find that. So.
Yeah.
We just have to support them in finding that for themselves.
Right. Last question. You ready? Okay. Yeah. It's still in the shot. It's like, do I have to, like, lean back? Lean back. It's like a low rider. I think I asked this already. How has homeschooling made a difference for our family? What difference has it made for our family?
Well, we don't do the commute anymore. We don't have to go to
That's a practical thing, but that's a thing.
The kids, like, we're the schedule of sleep schedule is... I remember having to go in there and wake up Selah.
Oh, yeah.
You know, at one point was like, wow. You know, I was thankful that it was me waking her up, not her waking us up.
Yeah. But, I guess it's a nice thing.
you know, just not having to do that is a, like, it's just an energy saver. It's kind of an emotional energy saver, you know, especially when you're, so those things count. And then, yeah, we just don't have all that. I was talking to someone the other day about how often when kids go to public school, like there's something, you know, it's not all bad, but there's something, some things that have to be undone by the parent when the child comes back. Now you have to undo something they're learning, whether it's ways they're treating their friends or, you know.
Or even ideological sometimes.
Yeah. So we don't have, like, that's kind of been minimized a lot, you know. So it makes it kind of easier from a messaging standpoint.
Well, thank you, honey.
Thank you. I love you so much.
But I really appreciated you coming and talking to all these beautiful mamas out there. If you enjoyed this video, give it a big thumbs up. And we will see you next time. Take care, be blessed, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye. So how do you support me and the kids? Rob is our breadwinner.
I have been a breadwinner, but that may change. She may be my sugar mama soon.
Oh my gosh.
And I just wanna, you know, I'm looking to shift gears at some point.